G'day mates, and welcome back to my mountain bike trail building channel. Over the last couple of episodes, you've seen me build some pretty spectacular features, but cool mountain bike features aren't the only ingredient needed to make an amazing mountain bike trail. One of the most important ingredients is what happens in between these features and how you link them together. For instance, this section of trail before the boner log was pretty dull and boring, with a flat corner that killed the flow, making it harder to maintain speed to clear the feature. Last week I fixed up the corner simply by piling up dirt and shaping it into a berm. The corner flows way better and it's much easier to carry that needed speed for the gap after it. To add even more flow and life to the section, I built this cambered roll up. It's angled slightly to the left so it guides you into the correct line for the following berm. Let's spice it up a little bit by building a second roller before this one. That way you can really pump it to gain the necessary speed for the boner log, or if you're already going fast enough, you'll be able to gap it. So I can use less dirt, I'm piling up a few rocks in the middle of the roller. I want to make these rollers steep, but that's a little bit too steep. You may notice that one side of the roller is taller than the other. I've done that so you can get more pop off the taller side, or if you just want to roll through it at speed, you'll stick to the smaller side. I think the rollers are finished and they are a lot of fun to ride. They're a little bit steeper, so at slower speeds they are great for pumping. If you're going a bit quicker, you're going to want to absorb them a little bit or go with the flow and gap them. But before I can give that a try, I need to build the run-in berm. Using hand tools and the mini excavator, I was quickly able to rough in the new berm, which means you can carry a lot more speed into the rollers. Check it out. Now that I've had the chance to ride the rollers with the run-in berm, I think I might have made them a little bit too steep. They're almost more like moto whoops that you really have to absorb rather than flowy rollers. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Should I knock the top off and mellow them out a little bit, or should I leave them aggressive? Check out this cable cam shot of Vic smashing through those rollers. I just changed out my riding clothes and started packing up for the day when I remembered that I was supposed to try and double this, so we better get back up there and give it another crack. All right, here we go. Wish me luck. Better than I thought. I think I need a little bit more pop, but there's not a lot of preparation time for it out of this corner. Like, it comes up really quickly. Oh, holy crap. That one was scary. My first attempt was definitely the best. My second one was pretty wonky. And then my third attempt was just a massive case. So I think that's it for the day. I'll leave that for future Luke to accomplish. And I'll try and get a more experienced rider down to show you how it's done. I think that was a huge success. The trail is really fun to ride. It's really flowy. So I want to do the same sort of makeover to the trail a little bit further up. Let me show you. It starts just below the stump drop and continues all the way down to that berm that I just finished. It's a long section of trail, so it should take a couple of episodes to complete. I'll ride it as is so we can compare it at the end. As you can see from this POV, the trail has a few issues. It's narrow and overgrown in places, the berms have worn down, drainage needs to be addressed. Don't get me wrong, it's a fun section of trail, but it could be a lot better. I'm talking bigger berms, rollers to pop off, and a trail that actually surfs the mountain. It's gonna be fun and playful and a great time at any speed. It's time to start working on this first corner. You come over the roller with a lot of speed into the left-hander. But over time, this berm has slowly washed away and the bowl has been filled in with dirt, pretty much making it a flat corner, which means you lose all that speed. So the plan is to make the berm wider and taller and add drainage underneath. I'm also going to increase the length of the berm a little bit so that it scoops you up the hill a little bit more. To stop leaves and other organics from getting mixed up in the good dirt, I like to clear the entire work area. The old berm was a little bit too narrow and had a ledge on the inside, which meant that it was possible to strike your pedal when leaned over. Because of this, I'm using the mini excavator to widen it, and with that dirt, I can build the berm taller. It's getting cold here in Australia, so I've just added hoodies to my online shop. Support me and the channel and stay warm this winter. I've just given the face of a berm a quick slap pack so that I can give it a test ride. I want to make sure that the entrance and the exit of the berm are at the correct angles. That is riding awesome. It is so much faster. It flows nicely. I just got to work out what comes after it so I can really work on the exit. But now I'm going to go through and just polish off this berm, make it look nice, clean up that bowl area, and really smack it in. When you look at this, most of you will see a berm, but some of you will see a dam. That's because the shape of the berm cuts across the face of the hillside. And when it rains, the berm acts like a dam wall, trapping water on the inside of the corner. Good drainage is one of the most important things on a mountain bike trail. If done right, your trail can last a long time. And if done wrong, well, it can wash away overnight. To stop the water pooling on the inside, I'm going to smooth out the bowl section, find the lowest point, and run a pipe under the berm so the water can drain out the backside. Always make sure that your pipe is angled downhill before you bury it. Now it's time for the water test. It's important to do this before you bury the pipe, just in case it doesn't drain correctly. That way you don't have to dig it up and make changes. Nice, that's working well. So this is the exit of the berm. It takes you up the hill over there. I think what's going to work best is if I transition into a right-hand berm, which takes you around the mini excavator and back down the hill. So you're really getting that sort of flowy surfing motion, cutting up and down the hill. I think it's going to be sick. While raking the area, I found this old stump that I'm trying to get rid of with the mini digger. The stump is bigger than I thought and it's too strong for my mini excavator. I'm gonna grab my chainsaw and just hack away at this thing. I don't need to get the entire stump out. I just need to lower it a little bit. Dirty wood is terrible for chains. It blunts it really quickly. I use one of my oldest ones, so it's fine. I'll sharpen it up and just keep it for my dirty cuts. I've done a bunch of cross cuts now, and hopefully that weakens the stump enough that I can come along with a mini excavator and snap the top off in sections using the teeth. That should be low enough to bury. Yeah, that's me looking like a dork, trying to visualize where I'm gonna build the berm. I also like to do some test runs so I know that I have the right line before I start piling up the dirt. With the basic shape in place, I can't resist giving this a test ride. Stoked that I test rode it because it's actually a lot of fun. It really just sort of curves around now. We've got that beautiful S-bend shape to it. I've done a little bit of work reshaping this right hander. I've widened the face of it a little bit. I've also scattered loose leaves on the inside of the turn. I like to do this because it defines the trail a little bit better, makes it look more natural, and a little bit less like a construction zone. That's done, it's looking beautiful. It's time to ride it.
Oh yeah,
about to do a POV shot with the chest mount and realized I've got a little hitchhiker. Welcome to Australia. Just spiders hitching rides on your bike. Get out of here, mate. I don't know where it went. It's still on there somewhere. Screw it, let's ride.
Dropping from a little higher up the trail, got this spider on as a stowaway. We'll give him a bit of a send, hey? Let's do it. These burns, still holding up. A little scandy quick, oh yeah. The stump drop, oh that was big. Here we go, new section. Roller, oh berm, second berm, and
If you're wondering why I keep ripping skids at the end here, it's because I haven't made this corner yet. Stay tuned for the next episode. Hold up, we got a t-shirt winner, DM MTB. If you want to win a t-shirt in the next episode, make sure you like, subscribe, and leave a comment on this video. If you want to support me and the channel, I have an online shop selling t-shirts and hoodies. They're really great quality, and the designs are all done by me. Thank you, legends, and I'll see you in the next episode.